Hi again, everyone. Chris Tisdell here again. In this presentation, I'm going to continue my series of videos on complex numbers. Now, in the previous video, I talked about the conjugate of a complex number. I showed you some properties of it, and I talked about its geometric significance. And in this presentation, I'm going to do an example of some calculations involving the conjugate or the complex conjugate. Okay, so let me share my screen with you and we can get started. Okay, so this is the example I'm going to look at. I've got two complex numbers, Z and W, and we're asked to calculate or simplify, I guess, the following and put them in the Cartesian form X plus YI. Okay, now just to refresh your memory, if I have a complex number z, which is say x plus yi, then the conjugate of z, denoted by z bar, is just x minus yi. So you change the sign on the coefficient of y. And geometrically speaking, if you have a point in the complex plane or the Argand diagram and you want to know where the conjugate is, you just reflect the point in the real axis. Okay, and there's all this sort of properties of the conjugate. Again, we'll employ some of those in today's example. Okay, so let's look at the first part of the example. Here I'm actually dividing a real number by a complex number. Okay, so let's see if we can simplify that. 25 over z. Now, we know from previous examples that when you're dividing a real or a complex number by a complex number, you multiply by a factor of 1 involving the conjugate on the conjugate. Okay, so if this is z would the conjugate of z bar would be 4 plus 3i. Okay, but let me just sort of make that clear. So z bar all over z bar. Okay, now if you wanted to, you could, you know, write 4 minus 3i down there, 4 plus 3i there, 4 plus 3i there, and then expand all the brackets out. I'm not going to do that, okay, because I'm going to try to save you some time with this process, okay. So z times z bar, that is in the previous video, it's basically just the square the sum of the square of the a and b of the complex number z. Okay, so here I can actually write that down only knowing z. It's 4 squared plus negative 3 all squared on the bottom here. Okay, and the top, well, I will write that out. Z bar is 4 plus 3i. So on the bottom, I'm going to get 4 squared plus negative 3 squared. Okay. All right, so that's 16 plus 9, so that's 25 on 25. So the 20 that'll cancel and you'll be left with 4 plus 3i. Okay. Now, some people will look at that and go, well, hang on, I prefer to put the 4 minus 3i down there, the 4 plus 3i there, the 4 plus 3i there, and then expand it all out. And remember that, you know, I squared equals negative 1. There's nothing wrong with that. It just takes more time than is needed. Okay? It just takes more time than is needed. So the way that I've got it here, if you know that z times z bar is always the sum of the square of the real and imaginary parts of z, then you don't actually have to remember that I squared equals negative 1. Okay? So that's a little time-saving technique that works for me, and I hope it works for you too. In the second part, we've got I times W times all of Z bar minus 4. Okay, now Z bar, as we found up here, is 4 plus 3i. If I take away 4 from that, I'm going to get just 3i. So this whole calculation hopefully will simplify nicely. So let's have a look at it. So z bar minus 4, that's actually, oh, sorry, let me write out I and W. So W is 1 plus 4i, z bar is 4 plus 3i, minus 4. Okay, so I can see straight away that the 4 and the negative 4 are going to cancel. So I'll be left with I bracket 1 plus 4i times 3i. Now you could, if you wanted to, distribute the I in there. It's not necessary though. Because I've got a 3i there, I'm going to team that up with the I over there, and I'll get 3i squared, which is negative 3. So, you know, I would cross that off with that, and then take the 3i and multiply it by with the I. Okay, so I'm going to get 3i squared, which is negative 3 times 1 plus 4i. Okay, now they want it in the Cartesian form, so I will actually distribute that negative 3. And there you have it. Okay, so I guess I'll write over here. Okay, so that's the answer to the part B. That's the answer to part A. Okay, now once again, if you don't like what I've done here with the Z and the Z bar down here and actually not writing down the whole part of Z and Z bar, then you can always do it the long way. Okay? All right, so that's my quick example. Hope you enjoyed the little shortcut that I showed you in part A. If you don't like it, then don't use it. I'll be doing some more involved and deeper examples involving the complex conjugate in forthcoming videos, and I hope you can join me for those presentations. Thanks for watching. Bye.